is recognized for 3 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I want to thank the gentleman from Pennsylvania for his work on this and his interest and passion for health care issues and the work that we do in this House. I also want to thank the gentleman from Vermont for his kind words and the work that he's done on this, and the gentleman from Iowa as well, who's been instrumental in moving this legislation forward. Mr. Speaker, many Medicare beneficiaries rely on a set of health care products and services that are classified as durable medical equipment, or DME. DME is often life-improving or life-saving, things like blood sugar monitors and canes and crutches and hospital beds and power wheelchairs and even things like oxygen supply and tanks. Without access to these items, many Medicare beneficiaries would not be able to survive or would see the quality of their life greatly diminished. In January 2016, Medicare started to slash reimbursement rates for these products and services as part of a nationwide rollout of their competitive bidding program. Mr. Speaker, I would suggest that this program is neither competitive nor is it a real bidding process. CMS now wants to extend these substandard rates and this substandard program to other areas, as you've heard, including rural regions of our nation, where these new rates will oftentimes not even cover the cost of the delivery of the item or the service, which means they just won't happen. In addition, this CMS program has failed to hold bidders to account. It's failed to produce rates that are financially sustainable for those who are trying to provide these services and items to patients. The National Minority Quality Forum has data that demonstrates that this program is driving up costs through avoidable hospital bills and inpatient admissions, increasing out-of-pocket payments by patients, and has led to increased mortality rates. Mr. Speaker, that's more people dying in our nation because of this program. In just my home state of Georgia, there's been a 20% decrease in the number of DME suppliers between 2013 and 2016. The number of medical equipment supply stores in our state has similarly decreased by nearly 40%. This legislation we have before us today, H.R. 5210, would provide a 3-month delay in the cuts, hopefully allowing for work to be done to come up with a real solution. This legislation represents a bipartisan commitment to ensure that Medicare beneficiaries continue receiving critical cares provided through durable medical equipment, particularly those living in the rural areas of our nation who would be disproportionately harmed by cuts in reimbursements. Again, this delay will hopefully provide policymakers additional time to come up with a consensus on a long-term solution. Every effort must be made to protect access to quality health care for seniors. I want to thank again my colleagues on both sides of the aisle for their work on this issue. I want to once again commend Chairman Pitts for his work on this issue and for the time allowing me to speak on this issue today. I urge adoption of the bill, and I yield back the balance of my time.